think about it. I think I remember seeing a visor. Wrath versus... I keep on thinking of Smash Brothers whenever I see the versus. Rogue Val, Hyde, Jack Bucket. Wow, I wasn't even freaking close on anybody. Oh, well, wait. What? The game just totally trolled me. There's no Bucket. Unless this is Bucket Mark 2. Skynet. Skynet is slowly infiltrating as cyborgs. What do I think about the cloak being removed from the decoy? I think overall it's fine. I definitely miss it. I miss the cloak from support too. I miss a lot of stuff from Legacy. But at the same time, I can kind of see why the average player didn't like it, because it wasn't as enjoyable. But at the high skill levels, I kind of liked a lot of those mechanics. Exactly, yeah. Yeah, it definitely made it a lot more streamlined and easier for new players to understand what's going on. So, same feeding route as before. Let's go ahead and see if they cut off the beach cave area this time, and then slowly move in. No, the food's getting away! Okay, so halfway through, 1:10 on the clock. So that means he's probably going to be expected at this rate to get stage 2 ready. Oh, any trap jaws? Trap jaws are really good. Oh, kill the trap jaws. Oh, that's 4 food. And usually if you kill a pack of trap jaws, another pack will pop up. It's hilarious. Like, you can get like 8 food in one spot. It's kind of interesting. Okay, here they go. I like that they're kind of holding the dome. Oh, here they come. Here comes the dome. This dome is interesting. So this top area back here is where the monster wants to fight, because there's toxic hounds and everything like that. Dark getting hurt by some... Oh, by blitz leopards. Really needs to be... Oh, they have to take care of that. If the monster sees this, she's dead. Oh, she's... Oh, it's the one bug. Look, she's half robot. She's melting! I haven't seen this bug yet. She's like corrosive Kala. She reminds me of the Gelf. Or not... the Geth from Mass Effect, with her little eye like that. Does that mean everyone looks creepy? Oh yeah, we got creepy skins, everyone. Talk about hackers. This person's invisible. Tron Griffin. He's Tron. Nerds. Okay, so not much is happening in this dome. Just a lot of evasion. Again, remember, the monster's on borrowed time, not the hunters. Oh, this trapper. That trapper could have gotten abducted down there and would have gotten murdered in that mosh pit. 100%. Super be careful. Yeah, at this point, just wait out the timer. Like, there's nothing he can do. It's not worth fighting him back here. He abducts you in this hole and you are just gone. There's nothing they can do. Remember, it's boring, but make the hunter come to you. And there's his abduct goes. Let's go ahead and see Torvald, the half-naked leg man. Wow, they're all coming out there. No, leave. 100% disagree. So disagree. No, because the assault could get... If the assault gets pulled back there, he's going to die, is the problem. Not even worth the assault going back in. Yeah, a 5-minute timer. That means, like, right now... Oh, and here we go. Monster is going to engage because they were out of position. They used all their jetpack. Really bad spot. Should probably go after the support. Support's all by themselves down there. Come on, Invisible Kyra, you can do it. There you go. Get a little bit of a shield burst going. Support goes through the teleporter. So there's no... Okay, so the medic has to survive on her own for 200... For a while. And there goes the dome. Monster is not leaving. They should really punish the monster. And the monster does go away. Monster might be able to catch up to the trapper. But the trapper is out of position all by himself. Yeah, if I was the Wraith and saw this trapper, I would just burn him down really, really quick. Hmm. And there we go. Monster. Nope, misses the pounce. I would never try and actually pounce somebody. Pounce on Wraith is really, really awkward to land. Like, I swear, like, her hitbox to pounce people is really, really low. Ignore the decoy. Ignore! Okay, so Monster heading to the beach, still not ready to evolve, and Monster has only 7 minutes left to work. So Hunters did a little bit of damage, half a bar of health, not bad. No strikes. No strikes is always a good day. With the Hunters, it's always more about surviving than it is to do without damage. Outside of like high level super competitive teams. Because at that point, if you don't put pressure on the monster, you just lose. But for intents and purposes, it's better to focus on surviving than it is to do a little bit more damage. So there is a spot over here that you never want to dome. You never want to dome the monster when he's right in this little area right there. If you do, that is the world's best monster dome practically on this map. The stats are literally 100% health. Basically, the monster has less health than the hunters because of strikes and things like that. It's not, there's like the survival odds are just they don't really mean anything in my opinion. Misses, does a little bit of damage. Don't throw the dome. Okay, now throw it. There we go. Monster gets domed. Stage 2, 3 supernova. Wow. Heavy supernova build. Medic out of position. Going to get punished here. And goes off the cliff. I don't know why you'd go voluntarily off the cliff in a situation like that. Knight getting focused now, which is fine because the medic doesn't mind. And there goes the armor ripper. Get some damage in there. Not much damage going on. And decoy being sent. Monster trying to stay up in the air. And is going to go after the trapper again. Really seems to be obsessed with this trapper. I really don't know why they're going after Griffin, to be honest. Although not getting any heals is a perfect reason to go after the trapper. And here come the Kyra heals. Kyra is low health herself, so needs to be careful. Because the Wraith can instantly change from trapper to somebody else. I did like the use of the thing. Medic should also be popping healing bursts. I'm not sure if she is or not. Monster will get away with a little bit of damage. Really bad coordination there. The monster going after the trapper should have been punished a lot more for that. Because the trapper is the easy to keep up. You're doing full heals, and you also have support. And then he can also just, you know, slowly stasis while walking backwards. Okay, so monster going to get away. Very little health damage. That was a 100% monster win right there. Monster is actually in the lead despite the odds. Again, the odds are literally just, you know, how much health to how much strikes. It's not really any scientific at all. Monster getting the 10% damage reduction. This is going to be really good for him. Also denying the hunters. But look at this. Hunters have 3.5 minutes before the monster just loses. So if the hunters just literally sat at the relay, there's a good chance that they might win just on time unless the monster commits a lot. There we go. There is the shield popping up. Nice healing by Kyra. Kyra should, yeah, stay up in one spot, not moving very much. Dome coming down in about 10 seconds. I'd like to see support give a shield here in a second. There we go. Little bit of a health. Really focusing hard on this assault. The medic should be doing a much better job. Medic moves positions. Shouldn't have moved. I don't know why she moved, to be honest. And assault will have his personal shield up very, very shortly. Nice healing by Kyra. A lot of good punishment. I really like that. Monster going after medic, but Kyra does move away. And monster decides to try and abduct. Going to miss the abduct. And should be getting punished a bit more now. And let's see who the assault or monster goes after. Monster tries to go after medic again. There is the drainer, but nobody's doing damage. Kala is really, really good in pre-mades, but not in an average group where they're not focusing on damage. Really high warp blast. I feel like that the monster is kind of not really focusing on any targets right now. Kyra, everyone's all grouped up, so needs to be careful. Remember, if you're not the assault or trapper, don't chase the monster. And there is Medic. Medic, it should always, like, your damage isn't significant enough that I would stay on your healing grenades all times. Oh, hitting by the warp blast. Heal yourself. Heal. Not shooting grenades at her feet. I'm not sure what Kyra's doing. I don't know what Kyra's doing. You should be shooting in the ground. There you go. There you go. That took a little too long. So the Medic right now, like, if I was playing, I'd know the Medic is the weak point because the Medic doesn't heal super optimally. Monster just hanging out in the sky, trying to avoid a little bit of damage. Just draining it out. Okay, and then support getting focused. A little bit more damage on the monster. One bar of armor, almost gone. They should be able to, oh wow, nice warp blast, hits everybody. Trapper being focused again. Medic needs to be very careful about losing line of sight. And here we go, finally health damage. Monster takes a minute off the timer, and it looks like the Trapper is going to go. The mortars need to be landing way, way, way further away. Monster committing, staying too long for the strike. Probably not worth it. Oh, there we go. Abducts, heal blast, shield, and the monster going to get away. More extra damage is always good. Good job on the hunters. It's interesting because there are misplays on both sides quite a lot. The monster was not really committing to one target or the other, and the hunters were really out of positioning. There's a lot of extra moving parts that didn't need to be moving. Like, the medic and support almost never need to move from their spot unless they're being attacked. Trapper and assault should be, of course, obviously line of sight issues and things like that, but generally speaking, you shouldn't worry about that. Let's go ahead and see this cheater. Look at that. Invisible cheater. Like, hacks. The Borg Queen has hacks. Now, be very careful about a Wraith that's this aggressive. Now, right now, they can keep up. Like, I would, like, if I was this team, I would pretend to shoot the monster, but never actually hit the monster. Monster did get the damage buff, so this is going to be really, really key. Knight is slightly out of position. Knight might go down here. Being engaged by Reavers. Oh, yep. Yeah. Oh, the Wraith should have engaged. The Knight is so out of position right now. And Wraith is not capitalizing on it. But not stage three. Only 2.5 minutes left. I would pretend to be shooting the monster and chasing him. And then just waste the timer. Force the monster to be very aggressive. So Knight of 19 was really out of position. So at this point, I just camped the relay. You know that the monster has the two good perks, the damage reduction in here. You could probably go ahead and get the cooldown reduction over here, but they probably won't be able to make it in time. But go ahead and set up at the relay. They don't really have any deployables, but they can definitely get working. Kala is on the team. Kala is going to be, again, instrumental in this fight. One strike on Griffin, two bars of health on Wraith. I don't think that's updated. I think it's going to be like two or one and a quarter or one and three quarters once this is actually updated. Oh, and he's going after the cooldown reduction perk instead of the damage. Personally, I think the damage is better for Wraith because your melee does so much damage that the damage is a little bit better. Okay, so let's go ahead. So again, Trapper out in the open, dodges the warp blast. You want to get out of that little... There you go, see? Just stay up in the air a little bit. And Decoy just sits there, thumb up its butt, because Decoy AI is horrible. And that's what you want to abuse. You want to keep going up and down on this wall as much as possible. Dark Dragon should really be punishing and doing permanent health damage instead of armor. Medic about to go down. Support should be shield. Where's the support shield? I don't see a support shield. Still waiting for a support shield. Kyra really needs to focus on healing herself a little bit better. She could go through the teleporter, and she's about to go down. Up against the wall, going to get ganked. Medic really needs to focus on healing grenades herself, and support really needs to be using that shield burst a lot more often, proactively, instead of waiting for it. I'm not sure what they were waiting for. The monster taking a little bit more damage. No need to armor drain right now, because right now it's got no armor anyway. So armor drain doesn't do anything. Monster is going to go ahead and get the strike on the medic. And don't forget, you can still heal burst while on the ground. There you go. There's a shield burst. Always be popping those when you're in combat. Support out of position. Support about to go down. Up against the wall. Just going to get meleeed here. Gets out of there. Not sure. It does kind of go back to the safe area. Two bars of health left. Will the monster be able to get this? It's actually kind of close now. 40 seconds. If they can survive 40 seconds, they might be able to do it. Assault should get support up. Assault, get support. Get support. Assault, get support. Oh, there we go. Took a little bit too long. You're buying time right now. That's all you're doing is buying time. So, taking a little bit more health damage. Two bars of health. Kala, again, really needs to use the armor reducer at the beginning of the fight. And then go ahead and use Banshee missiles. Okay, so dropship coming in. All hunters are available. They are going to be slightly out of position over here. And the monster does decide to go after the support. The support should always be behind the assault. It blocks abduct. Warp blast, you can't really warp blast through the assault. So the assault can stop that. No armor reducer right now. There's the armor reducer. Health damage. Remember, don't dome until the monster's running away. Get some nice punishment going on. The support probably going to go down. Go back down. Nope, going to stay up top. You never want to stay on the same elevation as the... And Kyra, where's the healer? Like, Kyra's healings have been a little off point today. Not getting herself, not getting other people. Definitely don't need to pick up people. There's no reason to. It just gives the monster two targets instead of one. Armor almost gone here. Nice Electro Griffin Harpoon. Medic. So monster is going to leave. I probably would not have thrown the dome either. That was a good engagement for the monster. But everyone was at half health. Kyra, heal. Heal. I'm not sure why Kyra's not healing. This makes no sense to me. There we go. Kyra really needs to be using those healing grenades a lot. Like, I'm not sure if Dark Castle is just relatively new to Kyra, but you have to be using those healing grenades all the time on yourself and on other people. I do like that they're preemptively putting mines out. That's really good. Now, if you can time it so you get the reducer going at the same time it's about to hit your little mine pile, that is amazing. So let's see if Kyra is going to survive with her, you know, hacks. And your half-eaten, fleshy Kala, cyborg. Okay, there we go. Okay, here is the reducer. Damage. Nope, no damage. Okay, so here we go. Let's go ahead and see where the monster is focusing. Monster focusing the medic. Again, I don't think the medic is the... Like, you can go after anyone else. Medic has not been keeping up with healing very well. Electro Griffin trying to... Electro Griffin should be out here. In theory. And then if the monster focuses the trapper, trapper can get healed. Medic about to go down. Starting to heal himself, so that's really good. But monster really needs to be punished here. Punish. Nice shield burst. I'm glad to see the shield burst more often. Just keep going up and down. Like Wraith has a lot of problems going up and down terrain. Monster staying in the fight. Going after Griffin now. Don't try and pick her up. Don't try and pick up Kyra. Okay, now you can pick her up because the monster's disengaging. Monster trying to warp blast. Nice dome. Outside. Oh, the assault is going to get the medic up. That is killer, but everyone's inside. Not going to get heals or so. No shield burst. Yeah, shield burst is a little late. I feel like the support and medic just are doing not a great job of keeping their teams alive. Medic about to go down. No healing, no punishment. Monster does have 25 seconds, so if the monster can't finish it out with strikes, has very little time. Medic about to go down. Medic surviving for half a second more. Assault popped his shield a little early. And there we go. There is the shotguns. Support coming back in, but support is really far away. And there we go. Support, and the hunters should have this. A little bit more damage, a little bit more damage. That's all they have to do. There we go, and that should be GG right here. GG. Really close, though. Really close. Support and medic just needed to do a little bit more healing and support as well. GG, that was really close at the end.
Yeah, GG.
Hey, Arendi, how's it going?
My shield wasn't ready most of the time.
No worries. Just always try and pop that off when often. Kyra, also, make sure you're always topping people off. There were a couple of times when I don't think you were reloading, but you and, like, the assault were, like, at half health. And so always just be healing. Remember, you can heal yourself. If you're jetpacking up a wall, you can shoot the wall and heal yourself while going up. The big thing against Wraith is just keep going up and down terrain. A lot of times you just go up and then you stay there, and then he'll just supernova you into a wall over. Clean out the sugar. Hey, my friends have sugar gliders. That's cool, Veer. Yeah, take it easy, Veer. Thanks for stopping by. Usually you want, and you also want to make sure that you're trying to capitalize. Luca, welcome to the herd. There was another one. I'm sorry. Give me one second. Let me scroll up real quick. Angry Rancher, welcome to the herd. I appreciate that. Those follows. It was pretty good. So with the armor reducer, you kind of want to try and see if you can get your whole team to focus. Usually I'll do the reducer when Griffin, Electro Griffin has his harpoon up and a couple of mortars are about to hit. And then also your siren missile, you know, mines are really good. But really good job of that. Otherwise, just to remember about positioning against Wraith especially. Wraith and Goliath have a hard time with up and down traversal. So just keep going up and down as opposed to just go up or just down and then keep going in a direction. And the reason why is because then they can just supernova you into a wall. But if you go up, then they have to climb up. If they go down, you go down. And so it makes it really hard. Like Wraith and Decoy especially have a really hard time with verticality. So always try and use that whenever you can. That being the case, really good job. Like, you guys really pulled it off. It was pretty even for a little while. Not too much going on. I did think that when the Wraith was in the first dome, you shouldn't have just chased him after there. Like, he had this one pit. If he abducted somebody in there, hit them in the air with a heavy attack and shoved them into the ground, that person would have just died. There was nothing you could have done to it. And to make it... Is there, like, an easy monster to play for a noob? I think Goliath is pretty well-rounded for newer characters. I think he's probably the best. Meteor Goliath is better than regular Goliath, in my opinion, right now. Meteor Goliath is a really good overall monster. He's not too weak, not too strong. He's a pretty good solid spot right now. So that should be a good one for you to practice. Wraith takes a little bit of finesse. So does Gorgon. So does Kraken. Behemoth I wouldn't recommend at all because his traversal is really bad. Yes, agreed. Yes, absolutely, Knight. So the game, like, it's very boring, but hunters always have the advantage in domes. The monster can choose the dome, and if it's not a favorable dome, the hunters have the advantage. And the reason why is because you can wait out the clock. So if the monster doesn't commit and just sits back there for 5 minutes, that's half the game time, which means the pressure is so on him. Like, at the end of the game, he only had 27 seconds left. So even if he didn't down one of you, he might not have been able to finish the relay before, you know, time ran out. So always be very aware that the hunters have the advantage, especially in the defensive positions, because if, like I said, that back area, you were all grouped up, they could have turned south very, very, very quickly with the right setup and things like that. So if you find that the monster's not committing or you're not doing enough damage, just pull back, wait for the monster to come to you. Yes, it is kind of boring, but you pressure the monster on time because he's on the clock, not you. So I would not have chased them out there, especially because inside the caves was a lot better fighting than out there. Out there was really scary, especially because the medic, like the support got hit by a blitz leopard and was at half health. And if the Wraith realized that inside the dome, I think the support would have gone down instantly. So always just be very, very careful about your surroundings and things like that. But yeah, really good game on both sides.